Hey guys, welcome to another tutorial. My name is Jesus Ramirez from MarketingUnfolded.com. In today's tutorial, I'm going to be showing you how to back up your WordPress website into your Dropbox account. Now, for those of you that don't know, Dropbox is a pretty cool service. It allows you to back up your files on all your devices simultaneously. The way it works is you upload a file onto your laptop, for example, and automatically it gets transferred into your cell phone, into your computer, and into any other device that you might have Dropbox installed on. On your computer, it looks just like a regular folder. This little green check mark here means that the file has been uploaded onto your other devices and onto the Dropbox website, which also contains all your files. So what we're going to do is we're going to go into WordPress, we're going to install a plugin, and that plugin will automatically back up our website into our Dropbox account. In case anything happens, we will have a backup of our website in all of our devices and on the internet, so you can back up your computer from any other computer, no matter where you are. So to do this, we need to go into your WordPress website. You need to log in into your dashboard. You need to click on Plugins and click on Add New. You need to search for a plugin called WP Time Machine. Click on search, and you're looking for the very first one that comes up, WP Time Machine by Paul Petty. Click on install, and yeah, I'm sure I want to install this, and it'll take a moment. Okay, now that it's installed, I'm going to activate the plugin. Okay, now that the plugin's activated, I'm going to close this for now and open my settings. Scroll down to WP Time Machine, and in these fields I'm going to type in my email and password for my Dropbox account, so I'm going to type that now. And my password. You can add the directory in which you want to add your backup to. I'm just going to leave it on the root directory. I don't really want to save it anywhere else for now. And I'm just going to click on Generate WP Time Machine Archive. And it's going to take a moment. Okay, our archive has been completed. And we can click on Remove This Message. And if we go back into our Dropbox account, we should see the file. And guess what? It's not here. Well, why isn't it here? Unfortunately, there's a little glitch with WP Time Machine that if you type in your password or your email incorrectly, it'll still say that it was uploaded successfully even when it wasn't. So make sure that you type everything correctly. So I'm just going to go ahead and fix my password here, and it should work this time. And I'm going to click on Generate WP Time Machine Archive. And this could take a little longer depending on how big your website is and how many posts and pages and images you have on your website. Okay, now that it's been completed, I'm going to click on Remove This Message. Okay, and then I'm going to go back into my Dropbox account, and I'm going to hit refresh, and here it is, WP Time Machine. If I click on this folder, and actually, I'm not going to do it through here, I'm going to come back into my computer, the folder, the Dropbox account in my computer, and here it is, WP Time Machine. Notice that it's still blue, not green. It means that it's still downloading some files from the website, and it just turned green as I was talking. So that means that all the files are now on my machine, and they are on all the other devices that I have Dropbox on. So I'm going to double click on this, and this is the backup to my WordPress website, and it includes instructions on how to bring it back. But I have my SQL files here, my htaccess files, my restoration scripts, and all my content files are here. So I'm going to double click on that. And it saved my WordPress installation, including my theme. I'm using Thesis 1.8. Everything is here. My custom files, my images, everything that's on my WordPress theme was also backed up. So if I were to have a problem with my website, I could just easily come back into my computer or any computer that I have Dropbox installed on and bring it back. If I'm not near of any of my computers, maybe I'm at a friend's house, and I need to do a restoration on my website right away, I can simply log into my Dropbox account on the internet and download the folder into any computer that I'm on. So that's pretty much it for this tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it. Go ahead and get yourself a Dropbox account if you don't have one. If you enjoy this tutorial, please come into my website, marketingunfolded.com, and leave me a message. Click on the like button. Also, feel free to leave me a message on Facebook. You can come into my personal fan page and leave me a comment or a question. And I hope you enjoy this tutorial. Thank you very much, and I'll talk to you next time. Bye-bye.